That is a big grand piano.
And playing it this morning is the beautiful Delta Goodrem. Good morning.
Good morning, Andrew.
Firstly, can I say how wonderful it is to be doing this with you on a Saturday.
Thank you.
This is great. And we've got a few people. Can you say hi, everyone?
Hi.
There's a few people. All at once, like a choir. There's a few people in the studio with us. We're just going to hang out for an hour or so, talk about the new album, Mistaken Identity, out on the 7th of November. Talk about some other things. How are you? I mean, it's a big weekend for you. You've got the Big ARIA Awards tomorrow night. You picked up 7 last year. You're up at 4 tomorrow. People may not realise that when you're involved in the ARIAs, there's days of rehearsals involved. How did your rehearsal go yesterday?
The rehearsal went well. You know, I'm really excited about it. Actually, it's like my first performance in Australia for a long time. Just to get up and sing Out of the Blue as the first song and just be there. It's going to be great fun. It'll be a completely different year to last year. I've got a completely different air about the whole thing.
We were backstage yesterday, James and I, doing our rehearsal for the award, and there's the Delta Goodrem dressing room, there's a Delta band dressing room, there's a Delta strings dressing room, and then there's the dressing room for Delta's choir.
Yes, right. Well, you're not meant to tell anybody that.
Well, it's a showstopper.
Well, hopefully.
Did you think, when you know you last played live, was it one of the last things you played was the Channel V show?
It was. Yeah. In Australia, that was like one of the last things I did. Performing.
That the next time you'd play live would be
a year and a bit later.
At the Superdome. We want to play the first single, Out of the Blue. It's pretty heavy opening lyrics, mate. It gets hits you straight in the heart. Can you remember what happened that day that you're singing about? Do you remember, was it a hot day? What were you up to? Were you taking phone calls?
You know, I remember exactly what I was doing when I wrote it. And I was sitting down with Guy Chambers at the piano. And there was lots of glass windows. We'd written 3 songs before this that were in a studio. And it was really mundane, really structured. It didn't feel right. So we went to this place, and it's Villa in his hotel. And then and I said, I wanted to be really honest and start from the beginning. And we sort of did exactly that, saying, a new beginning, a new chapter of my life. And started the day when I thought it could be my last. So it was really something I said, okay, well, I didn't think it would be my first single, but all of a sudden, how it evolved and people started taking to it around me.
And what was the first bit of the song you came up with? Was it?
Well, it was literally, I think it was definitely, just to jump over here, that...
Family of Friends, that's one of my favourite bits in there.
Family of Friends, they were my life. Da 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 da. Having that, I like that old, like, kind of, I'm not going to say Beatles-y, but Beatlesque, but that sort of old school. Da 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 da. Because I've written all these intense songs that I wanted one that was a little bit more, you know what? I'm still singing, let's go, you know, out of the blue here, this is great, we're writing music, so.
And do the doody do 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 do's they eventually become words? They eventually become words.
Exactly.
How many syllables do I need?
Exactly.
All right. Wish
family and friends.
Well, let's hear the finished product. This is the first single of Mistaken Identity. This is Out of the Blue. This is Take 40 Australia. Salute Delta Goodrem. We're live across Australia.
That was really nice, Delta. Thanks, Andrew.
New beginning.
This is Take 40 Australia. Salute Delta Goodrem live across Australia from Sony Music Studios. I'm Andrew. That's Delta.
Hi there.
Are you singing along to your own songs, playing along to them?
I was not, was I?
No.
Yeah, she so was.
They just not only singing along, Andrew, I was harmonising.
They just don't want to. They don't want to dob you in. Now, you were saying that when you heard that song, you were visualising how it's going to be when you play it in concert. I mean, playing a live tour is something that, you know, bands do pretty much straight after the album's released. You never had the chance.
Exactly. That's something I really felt that I've just missed out on. So I really can't wait to go. Now we'll have 2 albums worth of material, so I can get up there and really, I've planned really exactly how I want to do each song. And we're talking about how I'd like to do predictable and have like some interludes and just stop it and start it and just lots of things. I'm so excited because I just want to give back to everybody that has my songs and in their homes and say, let's come into my world, into the entertainment centre, wherever, and let me sing them for you, and you sing with me.
Have you drawn stage plots? Have you thought of
plots? I've done all of that. Yes, I have. Seriously, I have a book, and I have a little stage drawings, and I have little butterflies all over it, and they're like, Delta, how much do you think this will be? Oh, I don't care. Just make it unbelievably spectacular. You know.
That is sensational. A lot of the songs pretty much every song that I hear that you've written seems to come somewhat from a personal experience.
Yes.
How does the song travel from, okay, I got a phone call that made me sad, to here's a song on the radio? How does that happen?
You know, it's like I really can't sing a song that I haven't experienced before. I mean, every single song, there's actually something that's going on, and there's a reason why I've written it, because I mean, I have to connect with it. If I don't connect with it, then I don't think anybody else could connect with it. I mean, you can on the odd occasion. I think lots of things sneak through. But I think if you really believe in that very moment when you're writing it and you're being really super duper honest and you put it to words and you put it to music and somehow it all flows together, then I think it's amazing what can happen and what to talk about. I mean, I have to write it personally. And the thing is about this second album is that I guess lots of people know maybe a little bit more about what's happened. On the first album, no one knew what I was talking about. All they knew is that there was these songs that I was being really honest about, but they don't know exactly what I meant by in my own time. I mean, a completely different story to that. But now it's like I'm starting songs and they're going, because she was sick, she's talking about this, or because she met somebody in her life, that's why she's talking about this. So I guess people know a lot more about my journey. And this album, I didn't hold back in telling my thoughts and feelings into it at all. And I know that's kind of a bit scary, but at the same time, it's easy. It's the only way you can write.
I'm sure it's the thing that makes people connect with you a lot more, though, if you're much more honest in your music.
Absolutely.
And Mistaken Identity, the title track from the album we're about to play exclusively.
It's like the first time. Oh, yay!
First time ever.
favourite song on the album, sorry.
Oh, cool. Where did this song come from?
This song came from, literally, I'd written this whole piano piece. Hang on, let me just, I'm making lots of jangling noises. Thank
you,
Andrew.
I'll just grab your jewellery then.
I literally had written this whole note. I'd done this whole piano piece and I called it, that's called Mistaken Identity. Now, from there we sort of built up and I kept going, you know, da da da. And really just started humming along to it. And I took it to my friend Vince, my dear friend, and we both went there and we put down the demo of the music and it was called Mistaken Identity. So it was a piano piece I'd composed and it's called Mistaken Identity. And then when I went over to America for a while, I started to really reflect on the whole year and everything that had gone on and decided, why am I calling this Mistaken Identity and what does it mean to me? And I realized from even looking at old photos with the long golden hair and everything, I thought, you know what, like, that's, I want to talk about this and saying it's a mistaken identity now because I feel so different and it kind of started from there. Well, so it's my favourite lyrics in the whole album.
Favourite lyrics, favourite song. It's the title track for the new album.
Yes, that's right.
This is Mistaken Identity. This is Take 40 Australia. Salute Delta Goodrem. I feel very privileged to be here. Yeah.
Well, there used to be me. The first page smile, unpredictably wild, always trying to believe. I was always walking one step ahead. So I thought until the monster crawled into my bed. Rewind and erase that short look on your face, just cause you're Mona Lisa Reeves. There's a million words, a thousand days, the girl I used to be has a terrible case of mistaken identity.
Australia salutes Delta Goodrem live around the country. I might just put that camera away. That was an inappropriate camera shot.
Andrew's brought his handy cam out.
Come on. I'm shooting for Channel V here. I didn't mean that I'll raise over that bit. Come on. Mistaken Identity. That's the title track from the album out on the 7th of November.
Yes.
The second album from you, Delta Goodrem. As I just said before, you're... the vocal range that you're putting out in those songs is really, it's at the limits of, you know, as far as being able to hold. They're incredible notes that you're hitting. And obviously your voice is a thing you hold very dear to you and an incredible expressive tool. There was a time last year when you couldn't sing at all.
Mm.
Obviously, like, you're the kind of person that would sing every moment of the day.
Yes.
And then for months you couldn't sing.
That's right. I mean, it's exactly like an athlete being out for a while. And it's getting your voice back, being fit and healthy and making sure that you can sing the notes that you want to sing and make sure you've got your scale from there to there and make sure that you've got your range of working and really tapping into your tone.
So when you couldn't sing for yourself, like even just humming around the house, just going from place to place, you know, you immersed yourself in other people's music?
I did. I definitely listened to other people's music all the time. I really got to know other artists and tried to broaden my appeal of music and my range of what I listen to, and it was really interesting to sort of sit back and have a listen to other people's songs and watch other artists going out there, and while I was just at home, and I realized even more so that that's music's what I love and that's what I'm passionate about and that's what I'm meant to do.